Hi, and welcome to Mighty Math, the channel that makes all kinds of nice mathematical concepts accessible, understandable, and lovable. On today's video, I'd like to talk about one of the games played on Netflix's new hit series Squid Game, The Glass Bridge. No major spoilers are intended, but I am referring to Chapter 7. So if you haven't seen it yet and you don't want to know anything about it, maybe quit now and come back later. Still here? Well, on this chapter, the 16 remaining players have to cross a glass bridge consisting of 18 steps, each one of them with either regular glass that would break under their weight and send them falling to their certain death, or tempered glass that can hold the weight of even two players. So every step is a gamble with a 50% chance, or one half for success. If there are two steps to go, chances are one half times one half, a quarter. Three steps, one half times one half times one half, one in eight. And for the first player to make it safely to the other side, it would take a miracle in biblical dimensions. One half times one half times one half, 18 times, one half to the power of 18. A ridiculously small number of 0. many other zeros. It's easier to understand how small it is in terms of the number of possibilities. 262,144 possible paths and only one particular possibility that keeps that player alive. Even if we take out half of the possibilities for being too simple and neat, he still might as well shoot himself in the head. But whatever choice a player makes, the rest of the players awaiting their turn get some information about the correct path. Because even if the very first step is wrong and the player is, well, eliminated, the other players know where not to step. However, it is very unlikely that everybody would simply plunge to their death on the first step. So how many should survive? Completely unlike in the game. For this calculation, we will assume a few things. All choices are random and the players have no way of distinguishing between the two types of glass. All the players remember previous players' moves. There are no time limitations. There is no possibility of cheating, crawling on the steel frame, and so on. We are not trying to avoid neat patterns like 18 consecutive steps on the left or one right, one left, and so on, and we'll ignore all problematic mental aspects and irrational behavior performed by people on the verge of death trying to survive. Let's try to work out the average number of steps a player gives information about to the others before he's out of the game. As we said, information about one step is certain. So if there's just one step to go, it's not really interesting because a player would either get it right and pass safely or indicate to the others by failing or by falling where not to step. If there are two steps to go, then there's a 50% chance, a half, that a player makes the wrong choice. So we have one half times one. And if he gets it right, then we get information about two steps, the one he got right and the next one. Because again, right or wrong, we either know where to step or where not to step. So we have one half times two. So in case there are two steps to go, a player gives the rest of the players, in average, information about one and a half steps. If there are three steps to go, then again, even getting the first step wrong means chances of one half to get information about only one step. If the first step is right, we could say that we have a chance of one half to get information about more than one step, but we want to be more accurate, so we split it to the two options on the second step. If he gets it wrong, we get information about two steps with probability of 1/4. If the second step is also correct, the rest of the players get information about three steps, again, with a probability of quarter. What do we get? If there are three steps to go, every player in average gives information about 1.75 steps. It's obvious then that even with only a few steps to go, every player gives information about more than one step. I'd like to explain this average thing a little more. Suppose we had 1,000 people playing this game. We would expect about 500 of them to get the first step wrong, giving information about only one step. About a quarter of them, 250, would get the first one right and the second one wrong, giving information about two steps. And the rest, another quarter, would get both steps right, giving information about three steps. For the average, we divide it all by 1,000, the number of players, to get 1,750 divided by 1,000, which is 1.75 again. What we do is actually the same, only we take the fraction representing the probability for each possibility. The number we need to divide by to get the average is the sum of fractions, but this is simply dividing by one, so we don't need to. Moving on, if we have four steps to go, then again, first step wrong, 1/2 times one, plus 1/4, first right, second wrong, giving the rest of the players information about two steps, first one right, second one right, third one wrong, gives information about three steps with probability of 1/8, and finally, getting all three moves right, leaving the rest of the players information about four steps times the probability of 1/8. And so these add up to 1.875. If we do the same arithmetic for five steps to go, then 1/2 times 1, 1/4 times 2, an 8 times 3, 1/16 times 4, 1/16 times 5 adds up to 1.96875. 6 steps to go, 1.984375. 7 steps to go, a player would give, in average, information about 1.992185 steps. So we've worked out a general way to calculate the average number of steps we get information about from a player. Some of them would lose on their first step. Others leave the rest of the player's information about 5, 6, maybe even more steps. The more steps to go, the closer to 2. But even with only 4 steps to go, we are very close to 2. So we can conclude that in average, every player gives information to the others about almost exactly 2 steps. Some of you may notice that our sum equals the classical 1 + 1/2 + 1/4 + 1/8, with 1/2 + 1/4 + 1/8, and so on, having the nice and round sum of 1 if the sum is infinite. This is, of course, no coincidence. Not only is it consistent to work out the probabilities using this sum, but there's also a nice way to show the two sums are equal. Maybe I'll post a supplementary video to explain it in a few days. Anyway, I believe the way I've explained it is clearer. Now we have everything we need to answer our question. If every player gives in average information about 2 steps, we would need about 9 misfortunate players to go first and present their fellow players with the heroic legacy of information about all 18 steps, thus enabling about 7 players to cross the bridge safely. In case you haven't watched Chapter 7 already, I won't tell you how many made it safely to the other side. I could only tell you that the chapter's number has nothing to do with the number of people who actually survived the bridge. I hope you enjoy this video, and I hope you love math, because when you love math, math loves you back. But if you hate it, it hits you back with a vengeance. Please make me a happy man by subscribing, a like, maybe a comment, why not? Until next time, bye bye.